Hey, we are moving on with this. This has been cold worked a bit to get a lot of the scale off. You can see that it actually does have quite a bit of the raw steel underneath peeking through just from bending it a couple times on the end of a wooden stump. Happens to be a railroad tie. So, surface is fairly flat, fairly even. We are going to be evening this up. And because there is still scale on this, the best way to do it, to get rid of the scale, would be to use a hard abrasive disc or something like a bench grinder or an angle grinder with a hard disc. But since I have a used ceramic belt here, I'm going to go ahead and use that to get rid of most of the scale left on this and start profiling it. I missed the quench. Why? Because I thought my camera was recording, but in fact I had stopped the previous recording instead of starting a new one. Good and hard. Let some of that heat dissipate, then we'll move the blade and do the final bit. So if we want that edge to be tempered, we need to do that in an oven so that it's safe to temper it and we don't over-temper it. But at this point, the blade can be cooled and I can continue grinding without as much worry about the edge cracking, although really it should be tempered in an oven before I really don't worry about the edge randomly cracking. While this is still pretty damn hard, I'm going to go ahead and move over to a more or less fresh 80 grit belt. Sorry, this is a 36 grit. So this 36 grit ceramic belt, still pretty fresh and sharp. And I'm going to continue the rough grind on this. Hundred and 50 grit now. It's pretty shiny. See, my plunge lines are a little different, but that's actually to be expected with how this was forged. I'm gonna hit it with the Scotch-Brite, and anything past that, I think I'm gonna hand sand this, but that hand sanding will help clean up and even out these plunge lines, make them look a little more similar because the whole thing will be satin. Pretty nice. So there's a sort of a kitchen knife. Quickly forged out of 1095 8th by 2 inch stock. Up, rough ground, heat treated, finished ground. I still have to do the handle pins and the handle, but so far this is 2 days in, but I could have done this in 1 day, so this was a couple hours to forge, an hour or so. I could have done all of this so far in a single day, but I've broken it up into 2 days because once I was done forging it, I just left it in the forge to cool overnight. So that was an annealing process. Need to do the handle now, and then finish up the spine, finger choil, handle, sharpen, ready to go.